happening. No gunshots, but they getting.
Hey, what's up you guys? Craft Farms here, and welcome back to another video. Did I just hear the door again? Well, if you saw the last video, you saw that we were having some freaky stuff happen. Thought it was happening again. Anyway, today we are going to get this car running and get it into the inspection. So this video is going to be a bit longer, but that's alright. First thing we gotta do is we gotta get a 10mm wrench and get the dash put in, which is this right here, this big piece. Okay, and there are just the two. We could actually sit here and start it if we wanted. Okay, so now we need a 7. And then we need the RPM gauge. Because I have the choice of either an RPM gauge or the clock, and I would much rather have RPM than a clock. So we need to flip this over and tighten these to keep that so that stays in. And then we need a 6 to install it. Whoa, we're not making the car move. That's not good. Not good, because I could either go into the shelf or into the pit. Neither of which would really be any good. Okay, so now we need a 9. Because we need to put our back seat in, which is sitting right here. Seat rear, yep, I know it's the rear seat. So there are just the two. Okay, and we need the sub panel. That's what I'm gonna put in the car, because I want to get some subs for it when we do the aftermarket part upgrades. Next is the front seats, which each one has 4 9mm. We've already got the 9, so we're good there. So we'll get them both put in. And I want to be on this side of this seat. We'll get them both put in, then tighten them down. So here's one. Okay, I remember this one is like back here somewhere in a stupid place. Yeah, kind of is. Okay, then we'll go tighten the other side, and then we'll enter the car and tighten the middle. Okay, come on guy, make up your mind. Okay, And that's the last one. So then we need to go get a 10 so we can tighten down the steering wheel. Steering wheel. There it was, too. This dang enter driving mode thing is annoying. There we go. So let's just enter the driving mode, make sure our pedals work, gas, brake, clutch, wheel turns. Turns our tires. Okay, so now we need the radio. Can't go without one of those. I do want to import some non-copyright sounds music. And then we can play that in here. Okay, our headlights. So that requires a 7. So here's 1. Let's get them both put on right away. There it is. I'll just make sure to open the case back up. Okay, we'll tighten these guys down. Our car does need to go to the repair shop. That's where it'll go right away after we get done with the inspection, provided that we pass, which we should, hopefully. So now we need a 6, and need to put our grill on. Satsuma, I think is how you say that. Excuse me. Yeah, as you can see, our car on this side, it is not right at all. Okay, so then we have our 6. So now we need our hood. That is the next piece that goes on. This one I remember being a bit of a pain to put on. Or just to get it to tighten, actually. To where you tighten it. That's where it's the pain. Come on, it was on there. I had it. Where'd it go? I didn't grab this thing backwards, did I? No. Ah. Okay, so now we need to pull the hood lock. Okay, and will it open? Yes, it will. Good. That was much, much easier than when I did it. The first time around, it didn't want to stay on when I try and open it. Ugh. Man. Colds suck. And then we don't want to close it because we need to get in here yet. For our air filter, which also requires a 6, so we don't have to change wrenches or anything, which is good. And that just requires 2. I think I remember where the heck these are. Jeez, where are these things? Haha, there's one. And the other one's right above it. Okay, then we need to get a 10 to put on our doors. So this is the left door here. Okay, and then this needs to be tightened right here. And they all have 4. So tighten this down, take a look at it, make sure everything opens correctly. I think we can close the hood for now as well. So we don't need it until we... add our coolant and stuff. All of our liquids. We'll open our window. Come on, all the way, please. Oh, that's as far as it goes. Alrighty. Come on, close. Okay, we'll go get this door on. Our right door. I had issues with this one, too. Oh, perfect. That one fell off. The first 3 times I tried putting it on, it fell off. And finally, the 4th time it went on. The hood took like 3 tries before it would stay. It's crazy. Okay, so now we need our fenders, which requires a 5. Oops, wrong button again. So this is the left fender. We need to pick it up like this. And of course, I am too far back. Okay. So this... Oh, we need the hood open for that. I forgot. Whoa! Whoopsie. Probably should have secured that first. Okay. So this has 5 5-millimeter bolts in it. Each. So here's 1. Okay, where are... Oh yeah, there's 1 underneath. Okay, and then the rest of them, I think, are up here, aren't they? Yes. Here's the other 3. Oops, is that one all the way in? Yes, okay, good. Okay, I don't think we need to do that anymore. Ugh. There we go. Okay, and we didn't even check this door and see if it opened and shut. Perfect. We'll roll down our window. Okay, and then we need to pick this guy up. And rotate just like that. Okay, and we got the two bolts here. After this, we can get our trunk on. I like how there's no cables actually running to the battery. I just noticed that. Or is there? No, nope, they all run over there. None of them run to the battery itself. What the heck? So now we need a 6 for the trunk. Or boot lid, as the game calls it. Whoa! Play nice now. Okay, you know what? We're just gonna do it this way because it's not going to cooperate. And there is just the 4 on this thing, so. Had it. I've had it a couple times now. There it is. Okay, I need to blow my nose quick. Alright, now we got the trunk on, so now we need an 8mm to put both of the bumpers on. And each bumper has 2. So this is the front bumper here. There it is. Okay. Right there it is. We're almost done. Finally. Just got a few more things to do, and then we can start this thing. See how well it runs. See how much it smokes. Cause I know it will. It'll be running a little off, but that'll just take a little bit of tuning and it'll be all set. Then we gotta go down here to tighten these. And after this, we put our tail lights in. And then we start adding our liquids and painting. So here is the tail lights. And this is the left one. Okay, so now we start adding our stuff. So we're gonna bring all of our bottles in. First, let's make some room on the counter, actually. Let's clear up our space first before we start getting too far. So we can put this guy up here. We're gonna do a nice blue paint color, so the rest of the paint can all go up on the shelf. We're gonna do this color here. So everything else can go up here on the shelf, out of the way. Clear up our workspace, it'll make things a lot easier. Or should we do a red? Maybe blue and red? Yeah. We'll set the blue and the red out. Set those aside for now. We'll kind of mess with the paint options a little bit. Oops. We're kind of bunching our cans together here, but whatever. Whoa! Too much. Too much bunching. Whatever, I'm not worried about this stuff all being perfect. Because we're not going to be using the paint again. I highly doubt, anyways. Not unless we decide we want to change the paint. So then we just put that one up there. The jack we're gonna put in the car right away. This one anyways, the car jack. Come on, open up. There we go. Car jack. And we'll put that in the car. That didn't work. Go figure. Okay, you know what? Let's go right like this. Ooh, I nearly fell off. There we go. That'll work, and then this jack's fine there. Sledgehammer's fine there. Let's move this thing out of this corner so that it stops, so that it's not glitching through like it is right now. And then this thing will go over in this corner over here. We shouldn't have any spare parts other than our hubcaps aren't on yet. Those will go on. In fact, we can put those on after this. Gas can. Okay, so this we don't need. Our spare parts we can set out here in the yard. Because we don't need the clock at all. In fact, the clock, we're going to put it in the garbage. Garbage. And then this thing, we can set in the corner here. We might use it, but I don't plan on it. Okay, let's put our hubcaps on. Front, right. Front, left. Rear left. I'm surprised that it actually even matters. Like they all have designated spots, because these wheels are all the same, the hubcaps are all the same, so. But whatever. Okay, so. Let's bring our stuff in, all of our coolant, our whatever else. So we'll start with the coolant. That's what we're gonna need first. The 10 liter jug of coolant. Okay, so we got that. And we're gonna need to drink something here pretty quick or we're gonna die. Ugh, I gotta get this thing upright. I hate this motor oil jug. I have had more issues with this thing than I should. Ah, crap. Well, that didn't help matters any. Whatever. We got it now. Let's go set this thing in here. Okay, let's go take care of this thirst before we die. Because that would not be any fun. Although, really wouldn't be that terrible at this moment because we're at the yard. We don't need to do anything outside of the yard right now. I do have a couple. That place, they need their sewage pumped. And that place needs their sewage pumped. And that place. And this guy needs a ride. But I'm not giving him a ride right now. I'm focusing on getting this car going. Because to me, that is more important. Important at the moment. So there's one. This is number two. Do not fall over. And then finally number three. Which we'll lay there and then shut the door. And we'll get it picked up again. Alright, so now we can start adding our fluids to the car. So the first thing we need to do is open the radiator cover up and add the coolant. Oops. Okay. Not touching it, otherwise it'll mess up. So then this jug will not be empty. We only have to throw away two containers of brake fluid. The first two bottles will be empty, and then the last bottle will still have stuff in it. Okay, so now we'll get this put up on our shelf here. Then we'll put this back. And we'll open our rocker cover, our rocker cover cap, and add our motor oil. Ugh, if I can talk. Yeah, I'm not gonna touch anything. That's like once you see that little bar, you know, appear and start filling, it's like, whoa, don't touch it anymore. Otherwise, you'll be all messed up. Come on, fill. Fill on up. Perfect. Okay, so now we'll get this up on our shelf as well. Okay, and then we need to open all of these and start filling them. With the DOT-4 fluid. Is that that far back one? I don't know which one it is. All I know is there's three that got to be full. So then this will empty this bottle. I think. Maybe we'll be able to dump into another one. I don't know. Okay, where is the next one? Oh, this bottle is empty, okay. Whoa, what cover did I just start putting on? None. Good. So this can go in the garbage. Adios. Grab the next one. Okay, is this one... Does this still have stuff in it? No, it does not. Okay. So then that one's garbage. Oops. I wish they made it easier to, like, so that you could actually tell, oh, this one's empty. Okay, it's garbage. Instead, it's just kind of, you gotta guess and find out if it's empty. There we go. That's the one that we need to fill. So then this one is obviously not empty because we barely used any of it. So we can just set that up there on our shelf. We can replace all of these. Put in our gas. And then we'll paint the car quick. And then we'll start it. Okay, so let's just open this thing right away. There's not a whole lot of gas in it. There's enough to get the car into town, and then we can put some more gas in it, but... Okay, it's filling. Gotta let it be now. Oh, dang it. It moved somehow. Oh man, I had it. Oh, come on. Phil, for crying out loud. Why must you be so difficult? Come on, for crying out loud. Phil. It's kind of funny that this car doesn't have a gas cap. Phil, you dumb thing. Okay, this is really driving me nuts now. Maybe that's all the more gas that we've got. I don't know. Anyhow, that'll be enough for now, I guess. If it's not, we can take the hot rod and go get some. Okay, let's paint this thing. Let's just check out some paint options here. So, rims, let's do red. What? You can't paint the rim? Okay. paint our door. Our doors and hood. What? Paint the hood. No, not open it. No, don't open it. Oh, for crying out loud. There we go. That works. Paint the inside of our vehicle, I guess. And then our trunk. And then the rest of it will be blue. Doesn't sound bad to me. And then the red and the blue can then go up on the shelf. Oh, come on, really? There we go. I like that. Now, you know what? We'll do the whole thing red. Or blue. Sorry. I like this blue. That's a nice blue there. Nice color. I do wish it was a little bit darker, but it'll work. Alright, we'll get this put on the shelf, and now, finally, time to start the car. I want to get this hood open because... Come on. Oh, shoot. Gotta unlock it. Hood lock. There we go. Because I'm pretty sure we're going to have to mess with some stuff underneath of the hood. Yep, we definitely gotta adjust the alternator right now. Holy crap. That's annoying. That is extremely annoying. Okay, I need just the screw. I don't want to move it. How bad? Well, it's not actually smoking at all, so that's a plus. Let's just see if we can rev it with this thing once. Yeah, it's not. Oh, there's some smoke. There's the smoke. Alright, let's get this thing warmed up. So let's just check all of our gears. 2, 3, 4. Reverse. Everything works. Okay, let's get this thing warmed up. Didn't even need the choke. How awesome is that? Let's see, do we need to... Oh, we need to adjust the wheels first. So while this thing warms up, let's adjust the wheels. This definitely is a little car. So it's puffing a little bit of white smoke. Okay, so we need a 14. Oops, I didn't want to do that. It's So we gotta go underneath of the car here. And we gotta adjust something. There's one 14 millimeter on every single tire. So how's that look? You know what, everything actually looks straight, so we are good in that sense. So let's get this thing closed up. Let's get it put in the car, because we may need it later on. Let's drop it in the back seat through the window. Okay, so I'm going to pause the game here quick, and I'm going to go eat, and I will be right back. Okay, and we're back. Alright. So what are we gonna do? We gotta go over to the tractor first off. And you know what we're gonna do? Okay, let's mess with this fuel jug a little more, because I know when I did it, this thing had like a half a tank in it, and right now it's almost nothing. That's still open? No, it's not. So I know it should have way more fuel than that in it. Okay, we need to make a fuel run then, because this thing's pretty much out. And it's out.
We meet to you together.
Yep. Ah, crap. I should have shut it off when I went to eat. Okay. We need to take care of some stuff before we do anything, otherwise we'll die on the road. And that's... Oh, you stupid hood. Or trunk. Whatever it is. That's a diesel can, so that won't do any good for us. So that's no fun. Man, I should have taken that with and filled it on one of my trips to town. Instead, now we have to make a special trip just for it. Ah, we'll sleep. Heck with it.
Ay, 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 ay.
So our inspection is 300, so that'll drop us down to 7340. Okay, so let's get out of here. Okay, where's my lights? Here we go. Ignition. Okay. Hopefully we can get out of here. Oh, wait. It would help to have the gas can, wouldn't it? God. That would help a lot. A gas can and a flashlight. Both of those would be very, very helpful. Let's see, can we pick both of these up at the same time? I did not think so. It's cold. Okay, we can shut that off. Ooh, I threw that way too far. Didn't expect it to throw that far. So the place won't be open, I know that, but we can still get some fuel. So we'll just go back and pay for it later on or something, I don't know. Or maybe it'll be a gift. A gift that's not really given to us, just taken. Okay. Now we're all set. Let's get out of here. You gotta be kidding me. Mute the mic, because I feel like I'm gonna explode with sneeze. And then I don't even sneeze. We're gonna just pee on the boat. Not the most realistic way, or the best way, or anything like that, to do that, but I don't feel like pulling over just to pee. I wish the place would be open because, well, maybe I can get in there through the pub. I don't know if you can still buy stuff or not. Because we need to buy some more food and milk. I guess we'll have to just kind of figure that out. I've started to master driving this car. This thing is like death on wheels if you don't know how to drive it. There's a lot of times where I'm off the road, as you can see, but I hope you guys can hear me okay. I don't know what the volume is really is like for this part of the video, but almost on the highway now. That driving in second gear with this car is best. And then once you get out on the highway and get going, then you can, like, when you're going good on the highway, then you can go into drive and, you know, go like that. Whoa, I turned funky there. Then you can go, you know, however, but and end up dead. trap. Whoa, what the heck was that that just ran? Holy crap, I'm really glad we were driving as fast as we were. Because something ran across behind us, I'm assuming a deer, but it looked like the size of a horse. Whoa! Don't tell me this. Don't tell me this thing ran out of fuel. I didn't think this thing held fuel. Crap. Because I tried filling it with fuel one time when I was in town. I couldn't find the spot to fill gas. Well, crud. Now we gotta try and hitchhike or something. Yeah, there's no spot to fill fuel on this thing. Nowhere. Unless it's on the back here. And I'm sure this thing wouldn't take diesel. I'd be just way too lucky if it did. Okay, why won't it? Well, let's try and get it off the road then, at least. So that way it doesn't get hit. And I'm gonna try and not flip it, because I did that once before too. Oh boy. Oh boy. Oh no, 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 no. Not good, not good, not good, not good. Ooh, well that's one way to get it off the road. Holy. Hey, can we catch a ride with you? After you just totaled our car. Hey, hey, hey. Hey, I need a ride. Whoa, dude. Don't kill me. Let's see. Well, let's get this thing then. He doesn't know what he's doing. Let's. Whoa! No! Okay, I'm gonna get us so that we have fuel. I'll be back. That sucks. Alright guys, so it's been a week or so, but we're back. So the muscle car, I still have not figured out what the issue with it is. We're going back in here. Still haven't figured out why it does not want to start or anything. I see nowhere to put gas in it, so I don't know. The game has done an update, I guess, so I haven't really noticed all of what's different, other than there's some railroad tracks on this road, and the yellow car in town has a driver in it. There's a bus now, but anyway, so I went and got some gas. So we're going to go ahead and fill this thing up, get it going, and we're going to go to town and get it inspected and get going on that. So, I filled the gas can and the diesel can, and I filled the van up with fuel as well. Bought some more groceries. We're gonna need to go and take care of some hunger and some thirst here after we fill this. Hopefully this will like fill the car full. Gas cans. This is so stupid. Unless this thing's empty, I don't know. We have enough gas to get us into town. So that's what we are going to do. We are going to run to town, and we'll fill it up with some more gas when we get there. So let's fire this thing up again. Okay, here we go. See, the choke, I think, is on, but we don't need that. Wipers on, so that way they are ready. And we need our lights on as well. Drive through this crazy rain. We'll try not to die. And it's stopping good. I think something is messed up in my wheels because the car keeps pulling to one side. They must not be aligned correctly. My front wheels, anyways. What the world was that? Spin off the tires a little bit. Oh, shoot. I was gonna take care of hunger and thirst before we left. Oh well. We can do that later. Yeah, my wheels definitely are not aligned. Hopefully they will still pass the inspection. Now we do need to make a detour and go over to the tractor and get the warning signal, or warning sign, whatever. So here is the railroad tracks. I still have yet to see an actual train. I don't know if they added the train or not, or just the tracks. Oops, that was the wrong button. That was really the wrong button. Well, roll down our window now that it's nice out. Let's see, brake lights work, blinkers, Everything checks out. We just have to go get the warning signal off of the tractor. Really should have brought the toolbox with. Should have aligned these wheels. I don't know if I did. I don't think I did. I think I was going to, and then now I forgot. Boy, if this makes the inspection not pass, that would be bad. I don't know what that was. Maybe we need to go back and do that. Yeah, I really should have done that. This is... you can definitely tell that it's pulling to the left. Or to the right, I mean. Whoa. We're not even going that fast. Like, just imagine... when you start going fast, that would not be good. Okay, so we're gonna pull in here. We're just gonna shut that off. Oh wait, we're in a bad spot. Really bad spot. Now we can shut it off. Why is the tractor rolling? I set the parking brake, didn't I? Yeah, the parking brake's set. What the heck? Okay then. Car is way messed up. What the heck? Guess we gotta pay to have it fixed now too. The world. Okay, whoa. Stop. Oh, and of course it's going to start pouring on us again. Come on, get in! Get in the car. Okay, now let's see here. I need to remember. I don't remember what I need to do here. So we're going to go ahead and look. And remember what it is that I need to do. Okay. Okay, it just goes on the back. Right? How does it go on here? Okay, I guess I should have left that open, huh? Continue. Starting the engine. Yeah, I did not do this. Whoops. Okay, so I guess I just gotta put it in the trunk. Holy crap! I didn't even hit anything! That's ridiculous. Okay, maybe we are gonna have to repair this before we can even go into the inspection. But I doubt they'd pass it for inspection if it was like this. So we're going to take this in, see if we can get it repaired, and then we need to go back home. Actually, we're just going to take it in, get it repaired, and then I'm going to end the video. This video's gotten long enough, I'm sure. And we'll just continue this next week. It is this damaged. And I've done barely anything with it. Okay, so this is the repair shop up here. Okay, let's go in and see what this guy will do. See if he'll fix it for us or not. Hey, where's he at? What the world? Where's the guy? Hello? Okay, let's see if this sewage drain needs pumping here. We probably should have brought some food and stuff with us too, I guess. Nope, that thing's empty yet. Good enough. Okay, where is this guy at? Hello. That's quite the engine. Hello. Nobody is here. Absolutely nobody. What in the world? How do you get it repaired then? What's this guy doing? None. Okay, well, I'm going to save and quit here. And I'm going to end the video, and then I'm going to get this thing fixed. And I'll be back after that's done. And, yeah, so thanks for watching. If you enjoyed the video, be sure to hit that thumbs up button. If you're new to the channel, welcome to the channel. Be sure to subscribe if you like what you see. Be sure to turn on the post notifications to be notified every time I upload a new video. Be sure to check out down below in the description for links to all of my social medias, my mod site, my upload schedule, PC specs, as well as links to all of, as well as links to others. Ugh. You guys know what I mean. Alrighty. Thanks for watching, you guys, and as always, we'll see you tomorrow.